Many cities have difficulties to cope with the rapid pace of urbanization. The costs to extend centralized sewerage networks are very high and budgets are limited. However, many new urban developments have a high water consumption and thus produce large amounts of wastewater that require wastewater management. Decentralized wastewater treatment provides a solution as it decreases the cost of sewerage by avoiding pumping station and pressure mains, and often shifts part of the investment to the private sector and civil society. It also greatly increases the potential for local water reuse. This is one of the sanitation solutions to rapid urban growth and is a key component of citywide inclusive sanitation. In this module, we will see what decentralized wastewater treatment is, which technical options are available, how to plan, why thinking at scale is important, and considerations about the governance arrangements necessary to make it work at the urban level. Decentralized systems can also be called small-scale systems or distributed systems. However you call them, decentralized wastewater treatment can be defined by the following features: the scale of treatment at the building or neighborhood levels, the proximity of source to treatment, the possibility of on-site water reuse, for example for toilet flushing, irrigation, or construction. It can serve individual residential buildings, commercial buildings, hospitals and university campuses, as well as entire neighborhoods, residential complexes, and tourist resorts. In short, in situations where connection to a centralized system is either too costly, too complex, or too time-consuming to do, or where a connection to a centralized sewage system is not foreseeable in the near future. What kind of technical options are we talking about? Let's look at some examples on the ground. In principle, all technologies used for large-scale treatment plants can be designed at a small scale. A wealth of systems are available on the market. Most of them are small-scale activated sludge plants, such as sequencing batch reactors, or SBRs. They can also be low-energy systems, such as those shown in the following pictures. For example, an anaerobic baffled reactor followed by a polishing step such as a constructed wetland. As you can see, it can be very well integrated in the local landscape. Here is a beautiful example of a decentralized wastewater treatment plant serving a peri-urban neighborhood of Cochabamba in Bolivia, which provides treated effluent for the neighboring farmers. The choice of a system will depend on factors like space availability, potential for effluent reuse, and budget. If you plan to connect several buildings or a neighborhood, it is often possible to build simplified sewer networks, also called condominial, which save money and allow for local participation. In individual buildings, you may consider to separate black and grey water, especially where wastewater is stored in order to be collected by vacuum trucks. Treating grey water only is much easier to meet the reuse standards, and the volume of wastewater to be pumped out of the building is then significantly reduced. In this example, you can see the link between decentralized treatment, fecal sludge management, and water reuse. In the future, we could also think of separating all the sanitation flows for a maximal reuse of water, energy, and nutrients, such as currently pioneered in the nest building in Switzerland. Please consider the requirement for operation maintenance when selecting technical options, such as running cost, skills needed, and sludge management. There are many possible management arrangements for these systems. Systems can be owned, managed, and operated by different stakeholders. This figure from the Institute for Sustainable Futures illustrates the different possible configurations of ownership and operation. In India, for example, most systems are owned and operated by private entities, whereas in Indonesia, most systems are community-based. Now, how to plan for decentralized wastewater treatment? We found that common mistakes are to plan such systems as isolated pilots and to focus too much on technology. Isolated pilots tend to fail quickly after the implementing team leaves, no matter how great the technology may be. Why? Because the management structures are not in place. You usually cannot ask a community or residents association to run a treatment plant properly in the long term without external support, as shown by WSP in Indonesia, where hundreds of community-based systems were built. This case study highlighted the importance of co-management with local government and potentially outsourced private partners. Decentralized small-scale wastewater treatment needs some form of centralized support and monitoring, and that's a critical mass of installations. In short, think at scale from the start. Thinking at scale when planning for decentralized wastewater treatment is critical for the following reasons. To provide incentives for the private sector, both for technology supply and O&M services. To reach economies of scale in production and service. To get recognition for the role of decentralized systems within the water sector. To lead the wastewater utility to integrate these systems in its planning. To trigger the creation of dedicated structures with experts who are able to provide guidance, troubleshooting services, and monitoring. And to professionalize plant operation through capacity building and licensing structures. The scaling up of decentralized systems need to be accompanied by the development of appropriate governance arrangements and monitoring. Otherwise, the risk is high that they are not properly designed and operated and don't perform as they should. Let me illustrate this with the example of the city of Bengaluru in India. Following a national policy requesting decentralized wastewater treatment plants for buildings above a certain size, more than 5,000 units were constructed. The policy sought to address rapid urban growth and increasing water scarcity. It is estimated that 10 to 20% of the city's sewage is currently treated this way. This national policy allowed for the emergence of dozens of private technology and service providers. However, to date, many of these systems do not perform satisfactorily because the quick scaling gap was not accompanied by the development of the necessary management, monitoring, and training structures. This is our take from that. For decentralized systems to be embedded into citywide inclusive sanitation, the utility in charge of planning should fully recognize them next to the centralized infrastructure and fecal sludge management. Coordination between the relevant agencies is key and should guarantee a full overview of the systems in town. Monitoring and coordination can be greatly improved through digitalization. An app should be developed to match supply and demand of treated effluent in order to boost water reuse. Operation and maintenance services by specialized stakeholders should be fostered. Incentives should be developed to ensure technology selection based on sustainability criteria, especially the operation and maintenance requirements. In summary, we saw that decentralized wastewater treatment has potential to support increased sanitation access in rapidly growing cities by complementing centralized and non-sewered sanitation. It can also facilitate water reuse. It is a sanitation market per se, and there are a lot of technical options available. What is important is to plan for a critical number of units from the start, so that the necessary management and monitoring structures can be developed at the same time. Depending on the context where you're working, you may see such innovative approach as a risk. However, the number of these facilities continues to increase, and they need to be managed. The solutions and benefits are there. It is about defining the scope for decentralized systems in cities and the right synergies between the private sector service providers, communities, and public agencies in charge of sanitation. Thanks for your attention.